Hello!
Revelstoke, BC.
Thomas Middleditch here, welcoming you to the CBCB. Well, I tell you what, I for one can't wait to see some of these spots, or should I say, short films? Condensed cinematic experiences? I also can't wait to pass brutal and severe unrelenting judgment upon each and every one of them. We're gonna have a whole bunch of fun. So I believe, if my Canadian hasn't gone too rusty, give her.
Hey, so I got that job at Torchlight that I applied for. Yeah, it's like branding and promotions. They kind of gave me a vague description of it, but they just said take it and run and just, you know, see what I can do. I'm pretty excited.
I am all that stands between bland beer and hops lovers everywhere. I am the defender of malt, the savior of sours. I will make sure all hail ales, brown, blonde, and amber, far and wide, and let it be known I am the one true king of Kolsch, for I am the Torchlighter. I may not have been the hero they deserved, or the one they needed, but I'll be damned if I'm gonna let them extinguish the light that I shine in the dark corners of the brewing industry. Let it be known the Torchlighter will not rest until all the cans are craft.
We hit the streets of Nelson today to play a little game called Don't Talk Into This Mic and You Can Win a Free Beer. Here's what happened. Don't talk into this mic and you can win a free beer. Do you understand the rules? Do you like beer? Specifically Nelson Brewing Company beer? Even though you have a Fernie Brewing Co. hat on? He does like it. He likes it enough to win a free beer. Congrats, man. Now who's your favorite brewing company?
You got me a free beer hat, though.
wrong answer. Don't talk into this mic and you can win a free beer. Do you understand the rules? Do you understand the rules of the game?
You said don't talk.
You talked. I'm sorry. Don't talk into this mic and you can win a free beer.
Win.
I'm sorry you talked. Don't try again? Okay, don't talk into the mic and win a free beer. Do you understand the rules this time?
Yeah.
What's your name? I need it for the contest. You gotta tell me. All right, well done, 2-1. Nelson Brewing Company, do you like it?
You can talk now.
Oh. Yeah? Are you a fan of Nelson Brewing Company?
Yeah, they're great.
Don't talk into this mic and you can win a free beer.
I'm good, actually, today.
Oh, you lost, man. Oh. Don't talk into this mic and you can win a free beer. Do you understand? Yeah? What's your favorite brewery? If you could choose whatever beer you wanted, which one would you pick? You don't know what kind of beer you like? Why would you want a free beer if you don't know what kind? All right, she won as well. Now what brewery is your favorite? You can talk.
NBC, we were just there.
There you go. They were just there. Don't talk to this mic and you can win a free beer.
Don't talk into the mic.
Sorry, you talked in the mic.
Hey man, can I get an angry hen?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. We don't carry angry hen.
Are you f***ing serious? Are you serious right now? How do you not have angry hen? I'm f***ing this is bullshit. F*** you. Angry hen! Angry hen!
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. We scouted in yesterday. There you go.
Oh, that's what I needed.
Don't get angry. Get Angry Hen Brewing. Thank you.
taste of freedom. Mmm. Girl.
Remember the time you woke up with a hangover from having a few too many Nelson Brewing Company After Darks while celebrating your indoor soccer team's only win of the season? And you go to the fridge and discover that you're all out of the ingredients of your secret hangover cure, so you head to the co-op. And yeah, this was a while ago when the co-op was the other end of Baker Street, and you park in the no parking spot because hangover, and you stumble inside, only to emerge, having somehow agreed to go to the burlesque show at the Capitol that night with the cashier you've been crushing on for the last 2 weeks, the one with the dreads and the sarcastic eyebrows. And while you're trying to figure out what to tell your girlfriend who asked you to go last week, and you were like, "No, not my thing," she said, "Fine, I'll go to hot yoga in a jokey way that was meant to show you she didn't care, but she actually does." You almost kill a guy at the crosswalk. And that night, as you wait for her to leave, totally overdoing the whole, "Yeah, love you, babe. Hope it's not too hot, but just hot enough," all you can think about is what the Bianca Andreescu do you wear to a burlesque night.
If you change your mind, take a chance, I'm the first in line, honey, I'm still free, take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know, gonna be a round, take a chance, if you got no place to go, when you're feeling down, if you're all alone, when the pretty birds have flown, honey, I'm still free, take a chance on me.
In desperation, you call your friend Randy from Creston, and he's like, "Dude, wear a dress. It's a no-brainer." So you dig out a dress of your girlfriend's, and you are initially pretty stoked, but when you get it on, you feel like you should be going to a pretty in pink theme party, but totally wrong. And you have to take the bus, because your girlfriend drove to hot yoga. And when you get on the bus, you are trying to play it cool. Yeah, she's not laughing at you, she's laughing with you. "That's okay, I'm cool, I'm just a guy in a dress over here. Yeah, that's me, just hanging out over here, awkwardly, sitting in a dress." And then you get off the bus downtown, and as you walk down the street, you feel like you're floating outside of your body, and your mind is screaming, "What are you doing? What are you doing?" And you get to the front of the theater, and you wonder, "Is this moment going to change my life?" Remember that time? That wasn't our fault. Nelson Brewing Company. Proudly inspiring, potentially life-altering moments through hangovers since 1991.
In life, you've got many choices to make. Jobs, relationships, and everything else that gets thrown your way. Sometimes, it can seem a bit rocky. You may trip, you may fall. But as long as you get back up again and keep moving forward, your life is always what you make it. It's up to you to choose your own trail. Thankfully, when it comes to a premium craft beer choice, we've already chosen that trail for you.
Trail Beer Refinery, a companion for your road ahead.
We're from a faraway country, land down under, they say. Our mate called Trent said,
check out this place.
Yeah, we're on our way. We came to create Instagram envy, for landscapes, for likes, and for hashtags and views. We came for flowing rivers and mountains, and for hikes with mates carrying brews. We came to shred or die and yell,
yew!
For shuckers, for sleeping in tents. We came for epic road trips covering ground to see more of BC than Trent. We came to Chol Oot in a place where loonies and toonies are indeed not cartoons. We came for the place, and after wandering a boot, we felt like we'd earned us a brew. Came down to a place called Nelson, BC, where we heard it's the place to think clear. We thought that a month was all that we would need, but that was before we tried the beer. F*** me, that's good beer.
The rain, I've a smile on my face. I walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing, singing in the rain.
I'm not lost. I'm getting the beer, White Tooth. I know. I'm walking into the store right now. Okay? Bye. Where's the nearest liquor store?
I'm sorry. I didn't quite catch that.
Where's the nearest liquor store?
I'm sorry. I didn't quite catch that.
Where's the nearest...
Catch that.
Do you guys sell alcohol?
What do you think?
Do you have White Tooth?
How do you mean by that?
Huh? No. The beer from Golden.
Never heard of it.
Wait, what? It's the best! All their beers and their flavors, chocolatey, peppery, they leave not only a lasting memory on your tongue, but on your every sense. It's the perfect beer not to only just quench your thirst, but to drive your thirst for adventure, to push you to places you've never been before, to experience. What does that mean?
What do you think? Actually, that beer didn't sound too bad.
The nearest liquor store is 7.4 kilometers south.
Actually, that beer didn't sound too bad. 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 Actually, that beer didn't sound too bad.
It's never good enough, and we're always trying to make it better. And each batch is different, and we try to tweak it a little bit each time we brew because we want it to be, you know, the best we possibly can. And most people won't notice with the little tweaks that we make on each brew, but we can notice, and we hope that it's better every time we make it. There's beers that we've brewed, you know, 100 times that we still add small tweaks to it every time and just try to make it better, and hopefully it turns out better. I'm living the home brewer's dream by getting paid to make beer, so no complaints from me. Although I'm tired.
Thankful every day I come to work and be part of a great community, be able to be creative and do something I love. In the boil, adding hop additions. Always super cool to open up a fresh bag of hops and be able to smell that aroma, and then when it hits the boil, just the smell. It's probably the favorite part of the brewing process, other than, you know, drinking it later on. It's hard to wait 3 or 4 weeks to see how it's gonna turn out.
I wouldn't even be proud enough to say that we have the stamp of Roslyn, and that's kind of what the coolest part is that I wanna feel that we're always working towards that one day stamp of approval. We strive for the town to love us because we love the town. We're always seeking their approval. We're always wanting to be welcomed, and we always want to welcome them. So it's like it's literally a relationship that gives back and forth. Our company is a stamp or a reflection of the town of Roslyn, and we can't change that, and we would never want to change that. And we're called Roslyn Beer Company, with a lot of insight and thought to it. With all the funky names out there that we could have chosen, we wanted that name, and we don't really want it any other way.
Engine room to Captain Kirk.
Kirk here. What is it, Scotty?
You've been driving us too hard, Captain. That's what. The lads in engineering and I have been talking and...
And what, Scotty?
We're going on strike.
Captain's log, stardate 3013.3. Crew morale is at an all-time low. On the advice of Dr. McCoy, we are making a course change for a quick stop at Earth to pick up supplies for a crew get-down.
We will be in transporter range in Cranbrook, BC in 10 seconds. It'll be close.
Bridge to transporter room. Prepare to energize. 10 seconds. 9. 8, 7, 3, 2,
energize.
1.
Captain, is that what I think it is?
Well, Scotty, if you're thinking it's three kegs of Fisher Peaks hell-roaring Scottish ale. Yes, it is.
Hell-roaring Scottish ale?
Hell-roaring Scottish ale?
Oh, you're feeling better now, motherfucker?
Och, aye, Captain. That's all you had to say.
Okay, then. I'll be right down. Spock, you're with me.
That'll do it, Mr. Spock.
Bridge, this is Kirk. Sulu.
Lieutenant Sulu here, sir.
The kegs are tapped. Have checkoff, plot a return course, and let's get this party started.
Right away, sir.
Did you hear him?
I've been drinking vodka for hours.
Bridge.
Bones, this is a great idea. I can't wait to get shit-faced.
I fail to see the connection between drinking fermented barley and getting defecant on one's face. Or the logic of desiring such an outcome.
It's an old Earth saying, Spock. Drunk. Maybe you'll understand better when you get some of that fermented barley in that green blood of yours.
Dr. McCoy, with my Vulcan mind control and metabolism for alcohol, I would drink you under the table, to use another Earth saying.
This is the captain speaking. Check in.
All departments, report to bridge for an all-hands kegger. Don't worry about the ship. Lieutenant Sulu is our designated driver. Kirk out.
Oh, man!
Lieutenant Uhura.
Put on that mixtape from our trip to Argus 10. I love that one.
Yes, Captain. Captain. Do you remember the last time we heard this track?
I remember you. Wearing that sexy Andorian bikini.
I remember you had trouble in the bedroom that evening.
Captain, I just got a report from engineering. The kegs are already finished.
What?
He's going to have one hell of a hangover. But he'll survive.
God damn it, Sulu!
When you play with a good friend, they will love you for it. You can work hard, but take time to enjoy it. When you go outside, don't let the rain stop you. Throw one last cast. You never know what you'll get. Exercise. And take trails less traveled. Find solitude at your favorite place. Explore the outdoors. Whatever paths you take, enjoy the moment. And go for a beer at a special place where friends meet. Angry Hen Brewing, located in Caslow, BC.
All right, guys, so we've got our idea for Rossland Brewing.
Right.
Like, we've got our masks.
Master dial. We look amazing.
Yeah, we look amazing. Mm. You look amazing.
You look amazing.
We all look really good. It's pretty impressive.
Decent.
I mean, we all got the haircut just right. Okay, so we got that. I think it's still weird that there's a friends-based brewing in this competition, but, you know.
Yeah, and out in the middle of nowhere. You'd think if they were going to do, like, a friends-themed brewery, they put it in New York,
yeah,
maybe?
Yeah, like, you know. It would sell a lot better in New York, I'm yeah. sure.
And even then, a Seinville brewery would be better.
Ooh. So
it's just a weird choice.
Isn't Netflix already replacing Friends with Seinfeld? Should the brewery world do the same? And while we're on the topic, we chose Ross as our main spokesperson for this brewing.
I would think Chandlerland Brewery would be
Chandlerland Brewing.
I like that.
Phoebe World Brewing.
Joey Island Brewing.
The beer does taste great.
It is
great. The beer is great.
Yeah.
I'm really enjoying the beer. Rossland knows what they're doing.
Just a strange marketing choice.
I don't know. Maybe they really wanted to just go hard on the idea of, like, taking a break from lagers and switching to craft beer. You know? Everybody needs a break once in a while.
They wanted to pivot around the idea of large scale brewery.
yeah, I like the idea. I think they're doing it right. It's just weird.
What are you guys doing?
Oh, we're filming a commercial for Rossland Brewery.
You know it's Rossland, right? It's right over there, you idiots.
Oh! See, that makes a lot more sense.
Rossland Brewing.
The modern world, he's kinder, but seeing we, it's a reminder. Don't wear no suit. We're talking t-shirts. See how he flies. Makes women shiver. His voice is smoother, been bending notes just like his father.
Bree. Bree, I know we haven't had as much time to talk, but I want to get to know you more, and I trust you. And I think that I really want to use the rest of the time to get to know you better. Will you accept this beer? Honestly, I came here to find love and quality beer, and I just don't think I see that with you. And
okay.
And your bottle of homebrew is an insult to me.
Okay, that's fine. Absolutely. Yeah, no problem. It's cash. Don't worry about it.
Well, this has never happened before. So, Bree turned down the beer. Is there anyone else who would like Luke's homebrew tonight? Anyone? All right, unfortunately, you offered her a shitty beer. Absolutely. So your goodbyes. Okay, thanks, Chris.
Thanks, guys. Love you guys.
I'm fine, actually. Yeah, I think I made the right decision. I mean, I don't think my beer choice was so bad. I know it's not like a hip and hoppy craft beer, but I don't know. I shot my shot, man. But I actually, like, really wanted to make sure with Bree. Bree, will you accept this beer? I will. Awesome. Kevin gave her a better beer. So it is what it is.
Hello everybody, Dieter on the Mountain here, normally known as Dieter on the Bierstein back in Germany, where I'm a famous beer reviewer. So I'm making do, aeroplane points fell through to Munich. Speed review, Nelson Beers, Nelson Brewing Company, let's go for a stop, huh?
Thank you so much, number one little pucker. Let's try. Karl Lagerfeld, sophisticated, on the runway. Girls in bikinis, perhaps? Bramble. Disc golf in the woods with my mates, Ralph and Klaus. Miss those guys. Faceplant. In the boot room, Kootenay potluck, bluntstones, maybe some heaven and earth all together. Yin yang, they say. In Japan, I think. This one's the bent pole. Oh, Dieter just wants to get into a speedo. This one's dry, it's tropical, citrus. Maybe I'll pull off the phone. Okay, let's go. Over to Torchlight.
Yo, speed test. Awesome flavor.
Oh, I love the mustard so much. It's my favorite flavor. Are these mustard stains or bananas? Number three. Sakura Gosa. David Hasselhoff for sure. Knight Rider. Baywatch. His name was Mitch. Number three, on tour, Crimson Ale. Oh, out of the shower, American Hotel. Plug-in blow dryer. Why would you ever use a towel? Save the environment. Number four, level up, Hell's Lager. Oh, Hollywood Bowl, Kraftwerks, Sprockets, I'm in my black tights. And after the show, we go to the disco. Dieter out, thank you.
Okay, here we go, Backroads Brewery speed test. Number two, El Dorado Golden Ale. Arnold Schwarzenegger in the shower, coming from behind, squeeze really tight. Number four. Hey, Wiki, you're so fine. Autobahn, BMW, fall, going 180, head out the window, saliva. Number five, Marzen, German beer. Stag Hunt, Black Force, Musk, Adrenaline, rising from the moss. Number seven, Hippie Catcher Kolsch. My grandfather's name is Kolsch.
Oh, sorry.
Reminds me of my baby lederhosen when I was only 0.5 years old. I can still smell the leather. So thanks for watching Deed on the Bierstein. The Nelson beers are amazing beers. Makes you want to take all of the beers and put them into a river of beers. And I will call it All the Beers. And the brand will call Nelson Brewery Company Torch Leidenflaken Back Rodenstein. Deed out!
In Revelstoke, our history is steeped in the pioneer spirit. Mining, logging, and railroads attracted characters from around the world. Escaping from lands afar, these pioneers strove to create a new life where hard work and persistence could raise them up in society, in a place free of kings to forge a better reality and create their best life. These pioneers were hardworking men and women, and they helped build the West. They came around mountains, over mountains, and under mountains. From gold miners to gold medal winning ski jumpers, in Revelstoke, persistence and determination defined the time. Amongst these pioneers were the founders of Enterprise Brewing, one of BC's first breweries. It would operate for 60 years. Founded in 1897, it represented everything that the pioneers of the past had been seeking when they headed west. A new start, and the opportunity to prosper on their own terms. Fast forward to 1996, when Bart and Tracy Larson became one of the first breweries to start the craft beer revolution in BC. One of the original dozen microbrewers in the province, they strove to brew beer that would be unique, delicious, and sessionable. These brews would not be mass-produced in a factory or even in a big city, but in a place that would allow them to enjoy the mountain lifestyle. Named for the iconic Mount Begbie, the largest, most majestic, and highest peak in Revelstoke, Mount Begbie dominates the Revelstoke skyline in a way no building ever could. Today, Revelstoke continues to attract a new breed of pioneer, those seeking out a new life, far from the city. From the tops of the highest peaks to the bottoms of the valleys, these new pioneers are looking for the Revy lifestyle, a place where the great outdoors is important to life as a paycheck. Hiking, touring, skiing, boarding, mountain biking, dirt biking, snowmobiling, kayaking, climbing, mountaineering. They're all looking for the next big thrill, the biggest air, the deepest powder, and to go where few have gone before. They're looking for the joy in life and have a thirst for adventure. And the beer they drink reflects who they are, a beer that embodies their pioneer spirit. The gold they seek is not from the land, comes from one of Canada's most award-winning breweries, Mount Begbie Brewing Company. No matter where you live, you can taste the pioneer spirit in every Mount Begbie brew. The king is dead. Cheers to the new pioneer.
Hops are the body and the soul of a beer. Brings in all the character, all the flavor, all the aroma. Brings it all together. My name is Ivanhoe Liberty. I've been tracking hops 4 or 5 years, I think. I track native and wild hops in the Fernie and East Kootenays area. It gets scary sometimes. Hops are harder to find, like big game, you know, you hear them coming, whatever, you call them in. Can't call hops in, they got no ears. Anybody can go hunt. Finding hops is pure talent. Come from a bit of a long line of hop trackers. My grandfather was a hop tracker. His grandfather was a hop tracker. My father was a hop tracker. Got a couple uncles, a couple second cousins that are hop trackers. Might even be some in-laws, I think. I got some hop trackers. A few challenges that exist in hunting hops include getting thirsty, weather, dehydration, mountain bikers crazy, you know. The mountain bikers kind of like tend to like run over the hops, I think. Animals, gardener snake every now and again, like knife is blunt so you don't feel like you can get the right sample. You know, sometimes hunters go out there and don't find that big elk, and sometimes hop trackers go out there and, you know, they don't find the hop cones that they want. Yeah, it was a rough year this year for hops. Just been dry, kind of like fire season out there. A few music festivals are happening. They like seem to produce a lot of bass that might stop the growing pattern a little bit. And I got a pretty sophisticated drying setup in my garage. So the drying process is like one of the key elements of hop tracking. You know, like, I'm really stoked about next season. I'm gonna go to gym. I got a fitness trainer hired. You know, I'm not much of a reader, but, like, I've been trying to, like, get into the big words in these thick books. Yeah, hopefully I'll, you know, find the next big hop. Get it named, you know, like, after myself. Ivanhoe would be pretty cool. I'm really hoping to get in with the crew at the Fernie Brewing Co. I talked to one of the brewers drunk at the bar one night, so I'm gonna take advantage of that. They know I'm in town and I know where they are. I've heard rumors that the brewers are looking for some decent hops, and I know where they are. My words of encouragement for any future hop hunter out there is, you know, like, don't be afraid, like, just get out there and get it there. The hope is real, and can't spell hope without hops. My name is Ivanhoe Liberty, and I'm a hop tracker.